My name is Leanna Matthews. I'm a PhD candidate in the biology department at Syracuse University.
This is a spectrogram of a right whale call. So it's fairly low frequency because right whales are really large baleen whales.
My research is broadly focused on animal behavior and communication. Specifically for my dissertation project, I'm looking at reproductive advertisement behavior of harbor seals and how that corresponds to reproductive success. Also looking at a little bit of a conservation issue, looking at the effects of noise on these reproductive behaviors and seeing if there are any sort of human impacts on reproductive success in this population.
Leanna is a third year PhD student in my lab, and so she came up with this project at the end of her first year, and it's really, really exciting because people have been studying the impact of noise on cetaceans or in whales and dolphins for really extensively for about 20 years. But there's been minimal research in pinnipeds or seals and sea lions.
Humans make a lot of noise just inherently. I think anyone who's been to a big city knows that humans can be really loud. And what's interesting though is that the noise that we make in the oceans actually travels a lot further than the noise that we make in air. Sound in general just travels very efficiently underwater. So a boat that's kilometers away can still impact an animal or a population of animals if they're underwater. The award was really exciting. So it's a National Geographic Young Explorers grant, which they're given out to not only scientists, but just really anyone who's interested in exploring the natural world, either through, you know, hypothesis testing science, which is what I'm doing, or exploring underexplored parts of the world.
So the National Geographic Award is a very prestigious award, and it's going to enable Leanna to do a much better thesis than she would have been able to do without the funds, because it gives her more independence. And the part of the award that's really exciting is that it's for young explorers, and so it's sort of highlighting the work that we do is really exploratory. I have students going around the world to collect the data in the oceans, in the Pacific and in the Atlantic. I've had students in the Arctic and in other hemispheres. And so it's really exciting to realize the sort of global impact and global reach of this type of research.
This grant in particular is for sort of the first phase of my project, which is just collecting data on the acoustic behavior and the spatial behavior of male harbor seals. And so what I want to do is just kind of figure out what they're doing when they're underwater, where they are, what sounds they're making, and where they're making those sounds. Because this species of seal breeds underwater, there's a lot we don't know about their breeding system because we can't see it. So that's sort of the first phase of my project, is really picking away at what they're doing underwater. And this grant's also going to help with the second phase, which is looking at the reproductive success of males. So when you want to look at reproductive success of a population, you have to do paternity analysis. So I'm devising some creative ways to take hair samples from a large portion of individuals in the population and then do paternity analysis on that to sort of correlate the behaviors and the paternity.